They say that, you know, necessity is the mother of invention, and we believe that scarcity is the grandmother of invention. Devi Shetty is really quite a hero, not only in India but abroad. And this is because he has done something that even the most advanced economies have failed to do. So what's amazing about him is that he's applied modern principles of management, Fordism, you know, looking at division of labor and specialization and so forth, to reduce the cost of heart surgery to less than $1,500, where in the West it might be tens of thousands of dollars for that same quality surgery. And he has done this at scale.
For me, if a solution is not affordable, it is not a solution. We have to come up with innovative processes, innovative product to make a difference to the common man. And in the end, it has to be sustainable and it has to be scalable.
छूत वाली जो प्रॉब्लम चली है, स्केवेंजर्स लोग क्यों बने, उसकी सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम थी टॉयलेट्स का ना होना।
कि ऐसा शौचालय बनाया जाए, इसको स्लो शौचालय नाम दिया हमने, कि इस शौचालय को बनाने से मैला ढोने वालों को मैला ढोना पड़े।
I think in the case of Dr. Partek, the example that this kind of Jugaad mindset is exemplified in the fact that he wants to bring dignity to these people. The idea of essentially coming up with a very simple but effective solution, the idea is not to come up with, you know, a very kind of complex and very sophisticated solution, but something which could be simple and yet addresses a basic need.
The whole argument that people keep giving, खाने को पैसे नहीं है तुम इंटरनेट की बात करते हो, you know, रहने को घर नहीं है तुम इंटरनेट की बात करते हो, पढ़ने के लिए स्कूल नहीं है तुम इंटरनेट की बात करते हो, you know, टॉयलेट नहीं है और तुम मोबाइल की बात करते हो. मैं बोलता हूँ yes, I really don't need all that. I don't have all that because I don't have access.
Osama Manzar's story is another excellent example of how people, in solving a social and economic problem, have learned to do more with less. So he's taken this very interesting approach to piggybacking, you know, piggybacking up on the infrastructure that's already there to then breach that last mile.
Japanese food was invented because the Western designs did not satisfy Indian requirements. It's an amputee getting a Western design with a satch foot. Now it does not bend at the ankle. Now Indian sitting, Indian styles involves a lot of sitting on the ground, squatting. A Muslim, for example, or a Hindu going to a temple and kneeling before the God. Now, without this, he can't do it. So, and then they were very costly.
You have to boil your solution down to its essence. You have to also boil the problem down to the essence. What is that one big need that's unmet that you're trying to solve? And what is the one main way in which you're trying to solve it? So that actually helps you to reduce cost and make it affordable, to help you to do more with less. But it also has another very interesting aspect, which is the inclusivity. For people to be able to use it and maintain it, and so for it to be a long-term solution, it has to be simple. In the Indian context, Jugaad innovation is often about the form of organization and the service element. And Barefoot College is a fascinating example of frugal, flexible, inclusive innovation that involves people in providing the solution to the problem they face.
India first needs to look within itself and see the tremendous power they have, which is underutilized today. Respect it, identify it, and apply it on a large scale. Because what you really need are self-sufficient villages.